Music is having dots and lines on a page, and you turn it into beauty or art. It is a power to move people.
I saw a violin being made by hand. The person who made it, when he played it, it was a beautiful sound. I was about 4 years old at the time.
My father's a music teacher, so it was something that was always a part of my life. So in fourth grade, the minute I could start flute, I did.
So I started with the bells in middle school with all my piano knowledge playing this, and then I saw a trombone player, and switched over. Like, trombone isn't a loud, brutal sound, you know, everybody thinks it is. It can be quiet and pretty sometimes as well. That's why I like it.
A kid like Chris Trotter or Kimberly Mitchell are often in wind ensemble with the concert band. They're also section leaders, so they're training their peers. Friday nights are games and Saturdays are competitions. And sometimes on Sundays, there's parades. So there are times where we're going more than 7 days in a row.
Arts can give you something math and science can't. And I'm saying this as someone who loves math and science.
High school can't just be about athletics or about, you know, academics. Arts help a mind develop. You know, music teaches qualities. It helps kids be social.
It's great being part of a group of people who are so different yet have this one thing in common. And I've made some of my closest friends in band.
Yeah, I decided that I want to become an Air Force officer and got into the Air Force Academy. I still want to keep it with me. It's something I love.
They're musicians. They're real musicians. They're playing real Broadway books. They're players.
The great thing about music is that you have my friend who wants to be a psychologist and my other friend who wants to be a marine biologist and me who wants to be a physicist, and we all come together and we all have this one glorious thing in common. And we can play to our heart's content, and then we can go on our own separate paths, but this always brings us back together.